Era. Olha, tô parado ainda. Akosime, caramba, makosime, akagwegeru, abia makosime. Ogene, edemezene na bo. Good morning, family and friends. Welcome to the Wolf Nation, and also welcome to this new day, great day, beautiful day. Our day of joy, our day of exploring and enjoying life, because we are life, we are eternal, we are natural, we are infinite, we are unchangeable, we are indestructible, we are energy, we are frequency, we are everything good, we are everything perfect, we are 100% human. So I welcome you and encouraging you to enjoy your life. Also join us as we seek and spread the knowledge of actual truth without fear or favor or faint until the knowledge of factual truth prevail. So that is our calling. That is our mission. Our mission is to wake as many as possible up among our people so that we can begin to do exploits. It is the people that do know themselves that will be strong and do exploits. Not the people that do know their God. No people know their God. No, God does not exist. All right. So I want to share with us what I titled, Would You Accept It? And I will tell you, don't be stupid. Don't be stupid accepting whatever anyone say. Oh, because Pope said that you accept it. Because Bishop said that you accept it. Because the President said that you accept it. Because one organization said that you accept it. Because somebody or people in power say that you accept it. No, you have to use your own mind, use your head. Don't fall for their trap, tricks. Like I see how the Trump and his people use people to campaign during their convention, and they end up being that those people were tricked. They weren't told they will appear in that sort of thing. But you know, that's what politicians do. They don't care. They make the law and they break the law because they have layers of lawyers fighting for them in the court. Even if you sue them, you're gonna take many years. Sometimes the people that sue them will end up dying without receiving justice. So, because it is called wickedness of men, whether it's politics or religion, those things were established by wicked men for control. Okay, so you don't have to accept whatever that has been said. You have to investigate everything. You have to question everything. You have to prove everything, and worship nothing. Use your own head. Don't use your own head. Don't let another people think for you. Don't let another person think for you. Good morning, bro. So you have to place no authority over your life. I have seen some people, some educated fools, asking me, where is my authority? You know, from which authority am I speaking? There's no authority greater than me. There's no authority higher than me, whether it's your God or your mentor or your whatever, your leader. Is not greater than me. Whatever they have or they are is in their pocket. But me, I am my own God. I have no God over me. So I have these four questions that we ask and continue. Number one is, if you know that your ex-boyfriend or your ex-girlfriend have HIV, AIDS, or sexual transmission disease, that's STD. That's after maybe you guys broken up, then he or she was sleeping with different people and contact that STD. Would you have sex with him or her again? Would you do that? You know this person have HIV AIDS. This person has to used to be your ex husband, your ex boyfriend, your ex wife, or whatever it is. Would you still have sex with that person, knowing that they have that disease? Will you do that? Think. The second question is this. If you know that a room or an apartment or a house is in terrible shape. That's it, have leakage every the roof leaking when it rain coming through the windows, and you know it's not comfortable, you know, there's noise everywhere, nothing is working good, as they told you. If you know all this before you pay the rent or before you sign the lease or the whatever agreement, would you still rent it? Will you still buy it? Think about it. The third question is this: if you know that it is going to rain and you are dealing on some wares or some goods, let me use clothing. You are dealing on clothing material or clothes, or ready-made clothes and all that. So you used to put it outside so that people can see it and buy. And you know, if you know it's going to rain, would you leave those clothes, those your goods or those your wares outside when you know it will rain? Will you do that? Will you accept, okay, let me just put it outside, you know, God will protect my clothes, everything I commit into the hand of God is safe? You will say, crazy, you will not do that, you are testing God. No, it's not testing God. If you tell me God can do everything, God can protect whatever, God can keep whatever I put in his hand. Yeah, so God can also protect my clothes if I leave it outside and commit it into his hand and say, Lord, please don't let rain touch it. But if you know rain will come, use your common sense, use your own head, will you leave your goods outside there? Answer. Tell me. So the fourth question is this: if you know that, you know, the pieces of papers your thought it was a bread label or just piece of paper, but if you knew they are dollar bills, they are hard currency, good money, will you throw them inside the garbage bin? Will you just pack them and throw them away? No. So the answers to these questions I ask, if you are wise, if you use your own head, you know, is no. No wise person will do that. No wise person will have sex with somebody they know that have HIV AIDS or STD. No wise person will rent a room that is bad, a room that you don't have protection you don't have peace when you lay down, there is something coming to bother you or that. No wise person will leave his goods outside for rent to mess it up. No wise person will throw away money that, you know, this is money, this is not counterfeit, this is real money. You don't throw it away. So that's what I want you to apply. I want you to apply that answer. I want you to apply these answers or this knowledge to your belief to your belief system. Those of you that believe in God, some of you say you are working, but you still have that iota of belief. I think there is higher being. There is something that is higher than me. There is someone that is higher than me. No, the only thing that is higher than you is your ignorance. Your ignorance is God. What you know is science. So what you know is the answer to these questions. That's what you know. That is science. It is common sense. So apply the answers to these four questions to your belief in God, in supreme being. To your belief. Then let me put it this way. For those that believe in all these imaginary beings and fictional characters, if you know that God, Jesus, Holy Spirit, Mary, Satan, demons, angels, and all the characters in the Bible, Quran, and Torah, that they are all fake, they never existed, they are not real, they are not real at any time, will you still believe in them? Or will you still hope they will come to save you? Will you still do that? You have to answer wisely. Don't be stupid. Be smart. That one makes you a being. You are not a creature. A creature is controlled by its creator. You are not a creature. You are a being. That's why you are called human being. B-E-I-N-G, continue. There's no beginning, there's no ending of you. You are human being. You are not a creature. You are not a robot. There is no God that controls anything that concerns you. There's no God that controls your destiny. You are the one that have the ability to control your destiny, or someone else will control it for you. If you know those characters never existed, those beings never existed, will you still believe them? Will you still waiting for them to come and save you? Would you? You don't know, that's why you believe. You have faith because you lack knowledge. But when you have knowledge, belief ends, faith ends. You begin to follow facts, factual truth. I am calling you to wake up, my people. Don't be stupid, be smart, be the judge. Be knowledgeable, activate your brain. Don't be a dummy. Don't believe things because they tell you the book is holy, the book is inspired by God. Fuck that. Has you seen that God spoken to you about that book? If God is real, you don't need a book. You don't need a book to know the will of your own father. If you don't need a book, even a letter, to know the will of your living father, living biological father, what make you think a book written thousands of years ago is still the will of God for you today? And they tell you that God is the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. And the book they wrote thousands of years, they keep reversing it, changing it, and telling you it's still the will of God, and you're still accepting it. If your enemy, the person you know is your enemy, this person you know is your oppressor, and that person is the one that made up the book and tell you this is the will of God for you, and you look at him, he's not suffering as you are suffering. You are the one suffering. Will you accept that book as the will of God? But that's what many Africans has accepted. I don't blame us initially, because they beat that book into us. But now you have grown, you can read, you can study, you can do your own research. Why are you still believing their lies? It is time you wake up. I want you to know that a believer is a stupid person because they believe without seeing. They tell them, happy are you if you believe without seeing. Happy are you if you did not see but believe. No, stupid are you if you did not see but believe. Ahona Anyekwe is the main one. You have to follow the wisdom of Thomas. Even the fictional Thomas in the Bible, the fictional Jesus did not shun him for not believing what disciples say. He proved him, okay, yeah, you ask for proofs. These are the proofs you ask for. And that's it. Then they added that one. You know, blessed are those who did not believe, who did not see but believe. No. You have to see to believe. You say, blessed are those that did not see but believe. Yet you are buying car, you test a car. You test it, not just you see it. You test it to make sure it's running well. And you still believe in the lie they put, because that faith is the covering over your eyes, over your mind. You can't think for yourself. You can't see yourself. You can't see fast anymore. You are against fast. You are against truth. It is time you wake up and try to wake up, my people. Stop accepting their bullshit as God's will for you. Stop accepting their bullshit as your God. Stop accepting their bullshit as your Savior. It is time we wake up and rise up and fight for our freedom. Fight for our recovery. Fight for our restoration. Enough is enough. You say you don't care. You're coming against me in the name of your God, in the name of your faith, in the name of your belief. You are stupid, because every day Allah do another way. I see the God that lay down. He's laying on his skin. You say, no, you are against me for telling you factual truth. Stay there, you'll be suffering too. I'll be suffering, you'll be suffering. See, our people keep suffering. And you keep waiting for one God to come and do anything for you, or for one Jesus to come and do anything for you, which they can never do. If you know that it is not God or Jesus that gives you strength to make it in life, would you still be giving thanks to God or Jesus for your success? If you know that you are the one that wakes up in the morning because the sun rises up, you have connection with the sun. No God wakes you up, the sun, S-U-N, wakes you up. No Jesus wakes you up, the sun, S-U-N, wakes you up. But you wake up in the morning because you have been converted into a sheep. You say, good morning, Jesus. Good morning, Lord. I know you came from heaven above. How do you know you came from heaven above? Give me the date. You don't know nothing. You are just singing what you have been programmed to sing. If you know that you are the one that applied for that job, worked for that job, and get paid for that job, and succeeded because of that job, will you still be giving thanks to God? You have not seen, you cannot see. Will you still be giving thanks to Jesus? You have not seen or cannot see. It is the ignorant one that will keep doing that because they have been converted. According to Matthew chapter 23, verse 15, they are converts. They are not themselves. They are sheep of God. They are sheep of Christ. They are no longer human beings. Human beings walk and praise themselves for their sources. It is time for you to think. Then walk and praise yourself for your own sources. Would you accept it that you help somebody and the person you help go about telling people that it's another person that helped him or her? Will you accept that as right thing to do? If your answer is no, then why are you giving thanks to God that have not helped you in your time of need, have not shown up just because a book says so, just because somebody says so? Use your own head. Stop using their head. Use your own head. Stop using their book. Use your own head. Stop believing without seeing. You say you will believe without seeing. Okay, you believe before you see. You have to see after you believe. Grow up. Wake up, grow up, and live a better life. Peace.